Hi, everyone. Welcome. Bill Burt with Hector Longo on the Patriots beat, week five of the NFL season. And we got an interesting matchup here. Well, we just got rid of the Jets, which, you know, was a sort of a strange game, but I think probably played more into what I think the Patriots have to do to win. You agree with that assessment?
I think it was more the Jets having to do what to do to lose. But yeah, the Patriots did, like you say, they did handle the parts of the game that they needed to take care of. They handled. They ran the ball, they protected the ball, and they defended on third down somewhat.
Maybe a little on that. I think what struck me about that game is the Patriots won the battle on both lines, and that's not always been the case.
Not with the Jets, no.
So on to this game. This is an interesting game. It's the Cowboys. And really, I think we can honestly say the Patriots' defensive backs it's a guarantee they will be tested.
You know what's funny, Bill? Last week you said to me, how many teams in the NFL can beat the Patriots? Who are the teams that can beat the Patriots? Mm-hmm. And I never would have thought of Dallas. Then you look at Dallas to be on that short list. Mm-hmm. They're definitely a team that matches up well against the Patriots. Like you said, Miles Austin and Dez Bryant against those defensive backs, oh my gosh.
And they got one of the best tight ends in Witten.
Right.
And the Patriots do have trouble with the good tight ends. Go back to Dallas Clark there in Indianapolis. But I think there's another interesting element. We get 2 weeks of the Ryan brothers.
True.
And we get the second one, who has again had some success with the Patriots.
Last guy to keep them under 30,
mm-hmm,
when he was in Cleveland. So again, I think when you look at it on paper, you go, the Patriots should handle Dallas on their home field. I think there are a lot of intangibles that lean towards the Dallas' mm-hmm favor. Now, there's one huge tangible that is the self-destruction of Tony Romo that kind of leans the other way.
If you read the Eagle Tribune on Friday, you'll see what Hector's
yes
talking about. He has a column on Romo. Look, we got to be honest. The guy is talented, and he looks at times to be Brady-esque.
Yeah.
He looks to be as good. In fact, he creates more out of nothing than Brady or even the guy in Indianapolis. But again, we always seem to count on him messing up at a big moment.
The missed hold in the play for the playoff mm-hmm game, you know, that kind of sums up everything he's done since then. Mm-hmm. That missed hold that cost them the playoffs. It's just, you see him and you go, great arm, makes all the throws. Mm-hmm. Elusive in the pocket. Not a runner, but a very elusive kid. And just, he makes the bad throw, and you go, oh my God, what is he doing?
I understand your point about the Patriots could lose. I do think this is where Belichick is a master. As you have in your two-minute drill, why Belichick is better,
mm-hmm,
I believe the one thing the Patriots can do, they can adapt to teams.
And
while
word
this does not look like a good matchup, the Patriots, I see this as a game the Patriots are ahead by two touchdowns and letting Romo throw all his touchdown passes, but always from behind.
I feel like such a fan because I'm going to say, well, I hate all the sycophants around the team say, you know, they list 28 reasons why the Patriots shouldn't win, and then they say, I like the Patriots by a touchdown. I'm one of those guys mm-hmm this week. There are a lot of reasons why they shouldn't win. The bounce from the Jets win, so many different things. They can almost afford a loss. It's an NFC team. It doesn't hurt you in the AFC. They're just going to squeeze by, find a way to get it done. Win by a touchdown, win by 10. Like you say, Brady on the lead.
This game is interesting, that's all.
It's
interesting matchup.
Yeah.
It's not like the Bears, which would be a boring game.
Right.
Detroit would be exciting. But Dallas coming in, you know their game is to throw the ball.
Yeah.
And it is going to be a test for the defensive backs.
Right. They're going to throw it 60 times, whether he throws
60 times.
Five interceptions.
There's nothing to prove. They have nothing.
Six touchdowns, he's going to throw the ball.
All right, well, that's good. We'll get. We will be at the game on Sunday. It's a 4 o'clock game. So if you want to watch before the game, probably around 3, we'll have a pregame look. And at halftime, a quick one-minute summary of the first half. And then postgame, hopefully you'll make our postgame this week. On the field, after the game, a quick
summary.
I'm
so focused on getting the drill written, though, Bill. You know, so I got to break that focus. And
I thought it was your cell phone. Your cell phone was dead, but that's a whole nother point. So that's it for now. This is week 5. I think both of us say the Patriots.
Yes. Absolutely.
Patriots. I got the Patriots by about 10. Probably a fun, interesting game. We'll be back on Sunday. Make sure you watch us here on the Patriots Beat.